Hello, this is James with Lot Hill. Today I'm going to go over installing the URU 4500 fingerprint scanner by Digital Persona. This is the scanner that we use with our time drop software to automate clock in and clock out. First, go ahead and install the time drop software. You can do that through downloads on our website, lothill.com/downloads. Or you can pop in the CD and just run through the installation. Next, 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 all the way through. That will install the standalone version of TimeDrop. Next, you'll install the URU 4500 driver so that the scanner can communicate with Windows. And to do that, put in the CD, go to your File Explorer, open the CD. You'll see the contents of the CD listed there. There's the install guide, user manual, and there's also a folder for URU drivers. Double click on URU drivers. Next, you'll need to determine what system type you have. Is it 64-bit or 32-bit? To do that, you can right click on your Windows Start menu. This applies to Windows 8 and 10. Click on System. And right in the middle there, you'll see system type, mine is 64-bit. On a Windows 7 system, let me switch to that so I can show you what that looks like. You will click on your start menu, right click on computer, go to properties, and you'll see system type. This one's 64-bit as well. So that's how you check your system type. And once you know that, the 32-bit, you'll use x86. For 64-bit systems, you'll use x64. Double click on the appropriate folder, and then find the setup.exe file and double click on that to open the install shield wizard. This is going to install the driver for the biometric scanner. If you see the user account control message, just click yes to go ahead and start that installation. Click next. Accept the license agreement, click next, and then this is where you can set the installation folder. Usually you can just click next to accept the default. We're going to do a complete installation, click next, and then install. So basically next, next, next all the way through, click install at the end. This is going to install the driver for the URU 4500 biometric fingerprint scanner. Click finish, and then you'll need to restart the system. Now, when you restart the system, you will see a blue light on for the scanner. So that will tell you that the scanner is connected properly and is working. Once you've restarted the computer, go ahead and open up the TimeDrop Manager or TimeDrop Sign-In, as it used to be called. If you're using the evaluation, click Start. The default username is Manager, and the password is Password. That can be changed later by going to Employees, highlight your employee, double click, or click Edit, go to Security, and then change the username and password. First, let's connect the scanner to the system. So go to Manage System Options, click on Terminal. You'll select Digital Persona as the scanner type. May look like that already. Go ahead and click on Digital Persona. From the scanner dropdown, you should see a whole bunch of letters in there. With the name, which is indicating that that's the scanner. Select that and click Save. I've actually just reconnected my scanner. So I'm going to go back to Manage System Options, and Digital Persona is selected. Then you're going to go to Select Scanner, and from this drop-down you'll see something looking similar to this. Go ahead and select that. That's the hardware identification for that particular scanner. Select that option. Allow scanner to run in the background. This is important. So if the software is running in the background, so it's running behind another window or you have it minimized, something to that effect, that means that the scanner will still work and you'll still be able to clock in and clock out without actually bringing TimeDrop up to the front. You can require use of the scanner for clocking in and clocking out. This will hide the username and password fields, so only the scanner input will work to clock in and clock out. That way employees can't punch in their friend using a username or password. So they would be required to be there with their finger in hand and, you know, clock in, clock out. On the business tab, there's another option to allow clock in, clock out with username only. This option can be checked if you would like to allow them to clock in and clock out with their username only. So if you check this option and you do not check this option, they can either use their fingerprint or they can clock in with their username. If you don't check this, they can use, and you leave this unchecked, they can clock in with the fingerprint or they can use username and password. If you're going to use the fingerprint, you don't need to do either username or password. It's just you touch your finger on the scanner, it will clock you in or clock you out. If you choose to use username and password, then you can do that too, unless you have this require use of scanner only checked. If you check this, all you're going to see is a little fingerprint on the screen. That's indicating you use your finger. That's it. So I'll uncheck that for now, and then I'm going to hit save. Close the system options. The next step, now that we have the scanner configured, is to modify the employee. So you can double click on the specific employee or highlight, click edit, go to the security tab, and we're going to enroll a fingerprint for your particular user. So you would click on the finger that you want to use, then you need to scan the finger 4 times. There will be a blue light on the scanner when it's ready to scan. So there, I've done it 4 times. You simply click close and click save. Now that fingerprint is enrolled. To use that, you can click clock in or clock out. You can do username or and password in this particular case. Both fields are available, indicating that both are required. Or you can use your fingerprint. In my case, I used some part of my palm, and it's hard for me to, because I don't want to have my fingerprint on the video. So you would touch your finger to that particular screen, and this is what it would look like. Manager, password. You would see this. You're not clocked out. And then when they clock in, you'll see that. Manager now clocked in. And we'll go away after 4 seconds. Now that timeout, you can go back to the manager sign-in by using this menu option here, manager sign-in. This will allow you to use your fingerprint as well, or the credentials. So if you want a little bit extra performance, or not performance, if you a little extra information on that clock in, clock out screen, you can associate an image to a given person. So I'll add my picture here. Hi, everybody. Yay. Take the photo and hit OK and save. That'll put the photo in there. And then when you clock in or clock out, manager, password, there you go. You have your photo. And then also you can set that delay. If you don't want the delay to be 4 seconds, you can change that by going to system options, the close clock in, clock out confirmation message. You can close that. You can leave it open all the time until you hit OK. You can change the time to 2 seconds. 4 seconds is the default. And hit save and then X. So when you go back to here and you go manager, password, or you can touch your finger, it'll stay up for 2 seconds and then go away. There we go, now clock back in, or clocked out. So that's it for setting up the biometric fingerprint scanner with TimeDrop. If you have any additional questions, feel free to comment on this video or shoot us an email at product.support@lothill.com. Thank you.